Unit, Autons, and the Master? I feel like this has happened a couple of times before. Hello and welcome back to Mad Men Big Finish Review, a video series where I review some of the latest releases from Big Finish. For this week's video, I'm going to be discussing and reviewing the Fifth Doctor Adventures 42, which I believe should be the finale, because it kind of wraps up the whole whatever started with 40. To give a brief thoughts on 40, it was kind of okay. It was a bit of a disappointment. The first story with the Cybermen, I really enjoyed. The second story with the Ice Warriors, I didn't enjoy as much, but the overall mystery that they set up, I felt like they could have done a bit more with that, because it's just the whole setup of 40, both this one and both 40 and 42, is that the Fifth Doctor is being thrown backwards and forwards across his timeline. So a Fifth Doctor from, let's say, the present is thrown into the body of the Fifth Doctor, like, sometime in his past, and vice versa. So I wished the first 40, Fifth Doctor Adventures 40, kind of, you know, touched on a bit more of that, but it was more focused on the individual stories that the Doctor, you know, out of sync with his own time, is thrown into, you know, the Cybermen and the Ice Warriors. So luckily with 42, we get some answers to this. But going straight into it, because this is only one story. Unlike the previous box set, 42 is just comprised of one 3 hour plus story called The Auton Infinity by Tim Foley. Snowdonia Unit is running a training exercise with a brigadier in attendance, except it isn't long before things start to go badly wrong. The fake aliens primed to attack the troops might not be so fake after all, and a temporal disturbance attracts the Doctor, Tegan, and Turlo into the fray. Old enemies are on the scene with a deadly plan, but they might be the least of the Doctor's worries, because he's recently been sent backwards and forwards through his own lifetime, and he's finally going to find out why. Now, it's very interesting that it's just one single story, and I think that's great. That's kind of the problem I had with one of the problems I had with 40, which has been two different stories, and it's not touching upon the whole the Doctor being thrown backwards and forwards throughout his lifetime. It's just more about, you know, what happens in those stories by themselves. But very interesting that it was just going to be just the single story. And considering it's the usual standard price for a box set, I was a bit worried, would the single story, even if though it's three plus hours long, would it justify kind of the pricing of this box set? And I think overall, I really enjoyed this story. I enjoyed it much more. I enjoyed 42 more than 40. Even with it being one single story, it being three plus hours long, I don't feel like it dragged in a lot of parts. It was a nice, steady pacing throughout the entire runtime of this. As always, it's good to see, you can't really see, but it's just my go-to, but good to hear, you know, the Brigadier again. And of course, the Master, my favorite, of course. When I found out the Master was going to be in this, I'm like, okay, I'm definitely in. I mean, I was in already with, you know, the Fifth Doctor, because, you know, he's kind of my favorite of the classics. He's the one who I was introduced to with Classic Who, so I got a soft spot for old Five. I think if you've watched our live streams, I do have a copy of the Five Doctors signed by Peter Davison. So the Fifth Doctor with Classic Who means a lot to me, so of course I was going to buy the box set. I just had the added bonus of the Master being there, because I'm a huge Master fan. Which I believe John Coulshaw, who's essentially triple billed in this, he is the Brigadier, Chameleon, and the Master. Weird enough, he's not, in looking at the cast list here, he's not credited as the Master, so it's not like it's a secret. He is on the cover. It's not a secret that the Master is going to be in this story. He is literally on the cover. But there is a secret guest appearance in this story. I won't say anything. I'll keep it spoiler free as possible, as always. But everything about the story, I was intrigued with it. We finally got answers about what's going on with the Fifth Doctor, and it worked it ties in incredibly well with what's happening throughout the story. Because I thought, you know, because they even bring it up as like, oh, maybe the Master did this, you know, and it's always, you know, it's the Master, so he's messing with the Doctor's life as always. So I think that would have just been just kind of cliche, but thank God they didn't go with that, essentially that route. That was, is it, it's not really the Master that did this. There is a other reason that's tied to the overall, you know, Auton invasion, the character of Prodigal, who's leading the Autons. I won't go into too much about her character because of spoilers, and the Master assisting them. You know, nice little callback to you know, the debut appearance of the Master in Terror of the Autons, where he's assisting the Autons as an ally. But everything about this story, it was intriguing. It kept me engaged, and that is a plus, especially with these long stories. If it's a very very long story, you've got to find a way to keep me hooked in. A previous example was like this previous Seventh Doctor box set. The second story in that was about 2 hours, and it kind of lost me. I felt, you know, personally, it just was a story that went on for too long, and it didn't need to be about 2 hours long. And there's nothing in that hooked me to keep me like constantly engaged, wanting to listen, you know, keep going on with this story. But with this one, with the Auton Infinity for 42, I was definitely hooked in. I enjoyed everything about this story. The cover for this box set, I really enjoy. I regret not buying a physical copy. I usually buy physical copies because I only got a digital of the first 40. I went digital for this one. I might have to pay. I really want to get just the box set for this because the cover is amazing. We'll see. I'll look at my wallet, see if I can justify it. But overall, yeah, this story, interesting, engaging, nice little callbacks to, you know, kind of the previous Auton stories. Surprising that we're also delving into like the history of the nesting consciousness and all that, because, you know, there's the, you know, tying with like origins of different species is always like differing accounts, and the Big Finish or the TV show will always, or even like sometimes the novels, they all have different accounts. Sometimes they work together, sometimes there's discrepancies between the two, or how many there are. But it was a very interesting concept that they delved into with this story. But yeah, overall, I enjoyed this story. I think it was really really good. It was definitely a huge improvement over the first box set. The casting in here were great. I don't think there was a particularly anyone just felt out of place or weak in the story. Everyone played their part well, and everyone was essentially utilized. That's the best way I can say that. Everyone was utilized in a proper way, where they just didn't feel like they were just a background character that you could have just taken them out of the story and the story wouldn't change. Everyone had a part to play. Everyone was amazing in this story. So yeah, that's really all I can say about this box set. I'd recommend it. I think the thing is, you would have to at least kind of, I don't know, the thing is, they do mention, they briefly touch upon the events of the first box set, 40, so I don't know, I feel like you could maybe go into this by itself, but I feel like having the prior knowledge of the previous box set will help. But I would recommend this. I really enjoyed this story. So if I had to give it a rating out of 10, I would give it probably I'd give it an 8 out of 10. This was a really good story, thoroughly engaging. Absolutely liked everything about this. So definitely go, you know, if you have the money, and I'm going to force you to buy this, buy it now. You know, if you have the money, and if it's interesting to you, definitely go check it out. I found it very interesting, very engaging, so definitely check out The Fifth Doctor Adventures 42. But that is Unfortunately, that is all I have to say for this video. Thank you everyone for watching. You can check out any of my previous reviews. Remember to check out the live streams. We stream every week, and when they get around to it, check out my co-host videos. You know, like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, all that jazz. And I will see you all in the next one. Ciao.